down in Houston, Texas at the NanoRacks integration facility, and we did all of the final closeout checklist, and we said goodbye to our CubeSat for the last time.
This is a resupply mission for the International Space Station. So ours, the payload that we have, the three CubeSats from Virginia CubeSat Constellation, will be just one part.
We're working with two of the big state schools, UVA and Virginia Tech, have great engineering programs, and to be able to work with these two universities to build, deliver, and integrate CubeSats is really cool. It really puts ODU on the map. And you know, we're becoming one of the big, you know, state schools in Virginia for the space program.
It will be the first time an undergraduate design team has ever built and flown a real satellite from ODU.
It was very surreal, knowing that along the way there were just so many things that, you know, we had hurdles that we had to come across as far as the design, and things really didn't work out in the testing phase. And you know, we had to redo some testing, do some troubleshooting.
There were a few times we wanted to throw in the towel. There was just too much bad news. You know, we didn't think it was going to work, but somehow we ended up figuring out the problem. And it was just because that goal, knowing that there's a chance that a satellite we build ourselves will orbit the Earth and go up on a NASA rocket and from the International Space Station.
You know, we're here today, and all of that hard work and, you know, all those long nights in the lab really paid off. So all of the guys, I know they're happy. They had a smile on their face when we were doing our last checkout, signing over the CubeSat, and you know, working with the other two universities to finally integrate for the last time into the deployer pod before launch.
Well, how many universities in the United States have indirect, if not direct, involvement in an actual space launch facility? And it is my dream that Old Dominion University will be a leading spacefaring university because of our natural connection with the Mid-Atlantic Regional Spaceport.
The practical experience has really just been so rewarding. It's truly a good resume bullet to have to say, I've worked on a satellite that actually flies in space.
Because of this project, I have an internship with NASA. So because I had, you know, NASA CubeSat on my resume, my mentor who reviewed mine said, hey, this guy has done space stuff. Like, he knows what NASA's like what stuff we do. So it's because of this project that I got that internship, which may result in a job.
Knowing that something that you worked on, you physically put, you know, your hands on to help develop this deliverable is going to be just, it's going to be crazy. Saying, yeah, well, my reach extends 400 kilometers above the Earth's surface. You know, not many people can say that.